efforts around diabetes, diabetes tonight to honor the young man who found his way to being a disruptive innovator and using this very stressful thing in his life. Unless you're a diabetic, you don't understand the day in, day out stresses, highs and lows, and testing yourself, pricking yourself, so on and so forth. But to live with that and then manage to raise $30,000 on his own, 9 years old, that's remarkable. So not only to celebrate what we're doing here, also to be really able to celebrate him.
You're playing
Mike, let me know, Mayweather or McGregor. What do you think of that fight?
I mean, I think we all just are thinking of it until it really happens, right? I mean, you know, here's the reality, right? We know what goes on in the octagon, but when they finally get in the boxing ring, what happens when, you know, McGregor has a vulnerable moment? You know, his knee-jerk, you know, would be, it's that's what you do. If you've been training for years, when you're against the ropes to throw an elbow or either a knee, it's like that would obviously get him disqualified. So I'm trying to figure out, is it going to be in the octagon or is it going to be in a square ring? You know what I mean?
What do you
get in the ring? Mayweather's the A side. Yeah. Is it respectable for boxing?
I think at this point, you know, when you have accomplished all that they both have, I think it becomes fantasy. It's almost like, you know, when you see, and you read comics, right? I don't know if you guys read comics, but there was a huge comic book that I actually had, Superman versus Muhammad Ali. When you reach the pinnacle of your career, you start to do shit that's just fun, right? That's what I was saying.
What do you make of the people that say that Conor does have a chance, that he's bigger than Floyd, that Floyd's old? What
you can't ask
that?
Me that question because I love both of them.
Yeah.
You know, winning the octagon, I think that he's amazing. I don't know what's going to happen when he's under pressure in the ring. You know, elbow could ruin the whole shit. You know what I mean? So it's like, but we'll see what happens.
Canelo Golovkin, who are you going for on that one? How do you see it?
You know what? I'm really watching Crawford. I think that you guys should really give more attention to him. I think that his last fight was amazing. And if anybody, in my opinion, would have been an incredible opponent for Mayweather, it would have been him.
Well, they're saying him and Pacquiao at the end of the year.
I guess you got to go through Pacquiao to eventually get to the
yeah. Yeah,
but,
true.
I mean, Crawford is the man, you know what I'm saying? I've given respect to him, you know, in my gym, as well as all around the world. Every time I see him, I think the man is incredible. I think you guys should continue to
Crawford's
keep going.
Crawford's a big supporter of our morning show. Can you give him a quick shout-out so we can play for him on the morning show?
Who?
Terrence Crawford.
Oh, he's a big... Oh, okay. What up, Terrence Crawford, man? Listen, I don't know if you know him, I'm a huge fan of yours, man. Continue to do your thing. Keep it, you know, sit down, be humble. When you get down to your corner, remember that humility keeps you all the way at the top. All right.
Quick pick, Canelo Golovkin.
Huh?
Canelo Golovkin, quick pick. And why?
Canelo. Man.
Canelo?
Yeah,
really?
Yeah. I don't know. You know what? Actually, they both are incredible. That would be a horrible thing. I don't know if I would even bet on that.
That close?
Yeah, it is that close. Yeah. But he's not had many people who I feel can stand up to him other than Mayweather. You know what I mean? So we'll see what happens.
Yes, sir. All right.